So hello students, hope you are doing well. So in today's lecture we'll be discussing the concept of friend function in C++. Okay, so a friend function is basically a non-member function. Okay, it is not a member function, but it is a non-member function that can be used to access the non-public members. Okay, non-public members means the members like that are declared in private or in the protected section. Okay, so these are known as the non-public members, because public members can be accessed anywhere throughout the program. So this is a non-member function that is used to access the non-public members of a class indirectly. Okay, so a friend function cannot access directly the private or protected members of a class, but it can access indirectly to which it is a friend. Okay, so for example, if you take a real case scenario that you have a mobile phone, and your mobile phone can be accessed by the members of your family only. Okay, so your mobile phone can be accessed, this is a phone for example, so this phone can be accessed by your mother, by your father, by your brother or sister. Okay, they can access this phone because they are the members of your family. But what if anyone who is not a member of your family tries to access this phone? Okay, then it is not valid in terms of C++. Okay, it is not valid in terms of C++ because the data integrity is at stake. So friend function is also not directly accessing the data. Okay, so what if you are having a friend, what if you are having a friend and this friend is being trusted by you? Okay, this friend is being trusted by you, so this is a trustworthy friend, this is a trustworthy friend. So because you can't make any person your friend, in order to have friends, we just see some qualities, that whether this person is trustworthy or not, and etc, etc. So certain privileges have been given by you to this friend, that is a trustworthy friend of yours, so that this friend can access your mobile phone. Because you can't say that anyone, anyone that is not your best friend, or you can say if you are in a class of 50 students, then you can't say that all the 50 students are my friend. There are some students to whom you trust. There are some friends to whom you trust. And only these friends, there are only few friends, not all the friends, there are only few friends, and only those few friends have the rights that you have been that you have been given to them, so that they can access your things. Without your permission, no one can access your thing. So in the same way, in this context also, in a class, in this context also, in a class, this class is a owner. This class is an owner. This is an owner. And this class has given certain granting access. This class has given certain granting access to a non-member of a class. This has given certain granting access to a non-member of a class, and this non-member is known as a friend to this class. That's why it's been said that friendship, friendship is granted. Friendship is granted, not taken. So this is the statement that we have to follow, that we will, we will grant the permission to our friend that yes, please access my contents, because I have full trust in you. Kindly, I want you to access my contents indirectly because I have trust in you, because I am the owner. Not anyone outside, outside the periphery or outside the community, or outside the class can become my friend, until and unless I explicitly declare this member non-member function अ फ्रेंड इन माई क्लास. ओके सो अ क्लास हैज टू एक्सप्लिसिटली ओके एक्सप्लिसिटली डिक्लेयर द नॉन मेंबर फंक्शन. ओके द नॉन मेंबर फंक्शन एज फ्रेंड. ओके सो इट इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ क्लास टू डिक्लेयर एक्सप्लिसिटली ओके इन इट्स पेरिफेरी दैट यस नाउ आई हैव डिक्लेयर दिस नॉन मेंबर फंक्शन एज अ फ्रेंड टू माई क्लास. नाउ आई एम गिविंग माई एक्सेस राइट्स ओके दैट ऑल द प्राइवेट और प्रोटेक्टेड डेटा मेंबर्स दैट आई एम हैविंग दिस फ्रेंड फंक्शन कैन एक्सेस इट बिकॉज दिस इज ग्रांटेड. फ्रेंडशिप इज ग्रांटेड, इट इज नॉट टेकन. ओके द एनी मेंबर फंक्शन कैन cannot access directly to your contents, okay, until and unless you are providing the granting access, okay, so that's why friendship is granted, okay, so that's why we can say that we are making an indirect access, okay, we are providing an indirect access so that this friend function can access our contents indirectly, okay, so an indirect, you can say an indirect access mechanism, okay, indirect access mechanism is there, okay, not a direct mechanism. Okay, so most of the C++ community members, okay, they think that this friend function can break the chain of encapsulation or data heading, but it is not so, because until and unless, okay, you are not giving the privileges to any function, then how this function can, okay, can take your or can, okay, you can say make your data okay public to all. Okay, it's not like that. Okay, because there is a trust. Okay, if I am writing certain piece of code, then it is my responsibility that I am giving, okay, I am writing certain non-member function and or I am declaring certain non-member functions as friend. So it is my responsibility that what type of information I want to share with that particular thing. Okay, if the data member is not okay, is not like it is harming okay to my program, it is creating some, you can say, abrupt things in my program, then yes, I can easily grant okay the permission to the particular non-member function, and this particular non-member function can easily access the data indirectly. Okay, but it's not like that every friend function okay is very harmful or it is leaking the data. Okay, it's not like that, because there is in C++ community okay it's okay 50% of the people think that friend function is creating friend function is not a good thing, okay, and 50% thinks that yes, friend function enhances the you can say readability of the program. Okay, so 50% thinks that it is not a good practice, okay, and 50% thinks that friend function enhances the program, okay, the program's readability, or you can say it reduces the complexity of a program. Okay, so it is up to the user. Okay, it is up to the requirement of the user that if there is a requirement that we have to use the friend function, then yes, we have to use it. And if there is no requirement, okay, there is no requirement in our program of using friend functions, then yes, it can be okay, it can be ignored. So there is no a compulsion that you have to use a friend function, but there are certain cases, okay, there are certain cases in the programming that we will see in which okay friend function is must. Okay, if we don't use the friend function concept, then it is very difficult for us to okay to trigger the, you can say, the logic, or you can say to see the proper execution of a program. Okay, so it is a 50-50, you can say it is a 50-50 type of thing that you can use it, okay, depending upon your availability, and you can't, and you, if you don't want to use, so it is up to you. Okay, but it's not like that it is okay, it is making your data insecure. It is not like that, because you are the owner. Okay, you are granting the access. So if you are the owner, then how you can say that it is okay, it is leaking my data, or it is not secure, okay, it is not secure for my data. Okay, if you don't want to use that particular function, so don't use it. Okay, so the main benefit of the friend function, we will see okay the main benefit okay of using friend function. Okay, it is, we'll see in operator overloading. Okay, when we'll just, okay, we'll just focus the concept of operator overloading. So we will see that this particular friend function is very important in operator overloading, because there are certain tasks that cannot be performed with the help of, okay, friend function. Okay, so friend function is must in order to overload certain operators, or you can say certain type of, okay, operations that have to be performed between different types of data. So this is also a good, okay, this is a good concept that can be used in a program. Also, okay, if we want, okay, if for example, if we have different classes, okay, if we have different classes, for example, I have three classes, okay, and for example, these classes contain some data members, okay, these classes contain some data members, and, okay, these data members, okay, must be used, okay, such that, okay, if, for example, this is, okay, this is, these three are, you can say these three are the classes, or you can say these three are the modules, okay, of a project, you can say, okay, of a project or of a company, or a company is dealing with three projects. Okay, you can say the company is dealing with three projects. So this is, you can say project A, this is project B, and this is project C. Okay, so each project is dealing, okay, with certain revenue. Okay, and there are certain factors, okay, with the help of which the revenue of the company is calculated. Okay, so the data members, these data members are the factors with the help of which we can calculate the revenue of the company. Okay, so for example, okay, REVA is the revenue of company A. Okay, REVB is the revenue of company B, and REVC is the revenue of company C that has been calculated based on the, okay, the data members, or based on some processing that has been done on these data members. Okay, so there are some functions, okay, that will be invoked, okay, or that will access these data members. So for example, okay, f of a is the function, okay, that will be used in order to access these data members that are responsible in calculating the revenue of, okay, of, you can say, project A. And f of b is the function that is responsible in accessing the data members that is, that will calculate the revenue b for the project b. And similarly, f of c is the function that is responsible in calculating the revenue based on the data members that it will access, okay, of project c. Okay, so we have to calculate different functions in order to calculate the revenue. And in order to calculate the overall revenue of the company, because these three projects are the projects of a single company. For example, okay, the company is, for example, Microsoft or any ABC company, okay, or any company. Okay, so for example, the company is Microsoft. So Microsoft wants that I want to share my revenues or my quarterly profit. So what it will do, it will just, okay, add all these revenue, okay, revenue from A plus revenue from B plus revenue from C. So all these revenues will be added, and a final revenue will be, or a final, you can say, profit will be calculated. Okay, so what it will do, it will again create, okay, it will again create a function that is, that is calculating, okay, that is calculating the revenue, that is calculating the overall revenue. Okay, so a function is there that is calculating the overall, okay, revenue. So now you can see, okay, in this particular small scenario, there is a class, the class contains some data members, the data members can be accessed by this function of the same class, and a revenue of that particular class is generated. So here we have, for three classes, we have three different functions, okay, and if we have three different functions, then we can say that the size of the code is also increased. Okay, but if we don't want to create a different functions in a program, then we can directly create a friend, okay, to all these three classes. Okay, we can directly create a friend to all these three classes. So this friend will now be responsible in accessing the data members of class A, of class B, and of class C. Okay, and it will process, the results, that is the addition operation, will be performed in a single function that is known as the friend function, that is common to all these classes, that has been declared to all these classes. So what we have done, we have just reduced the size of the code. Okay, so in order to reduce the complexity, okay, so we have just removed, okay, these particular functions, okay, function A, function B and function C, we have just removed, and we have created a function, okay, we have created a function that is, okay, add, and we have created this function as friend. So now this friend will be, okay, declared in this class A, it will be declared in this class A, it will be declared in this class C. Okay, so it will be declared in class A, class B and class C. It means to all these three classes, this is a friend, and this friend has a property, because all these three classes has granted the privileges, that now this friend function can access its private authoritative data members, and as a result of which, okay, the summation, the overall, you can see the overall revenue can be, okay, like revenue of A plus revenue of B plus revenue of C can be calculated, okay, with this single function only. Okay, with this single function only, now we can calculate the overall revenue in spite of creating different functions of all different classes. Okay, so this is an advantage. Okay, this is enhancing. Okay, this is enhancing our, you can say, code readability also, and this is also reducing the complexity of writing too many functions in our program. Okay, so this can also be done with the help of a friend function. So we'll just see a small program, okay, that how this friend function works.